Hey guys, it's Ginny Silver, and today I want to talk to those of you who need to know how to build your own website. For those of you that do not have a website, or for those of you that have an outdated, subpar website, I'm going to walk you through exactly how you can build a beautiful website using Wix. Now, today's video is sponsored by Wix. Wix helps you to create a high-quality, beautiful website. Wix offers a vast array of beautiful templates to choose from and customize, a variety of high-quality features to embed, and it comes equipped with a user-friendly editor that allows you to create a site that is high in quality, beautiful to look at, and fun to create. Now, having a website is something that I feel that everyone should have. Whether you are new to self-employment or you are just looking at starting a brand new business, or if you have been in business and self-employed for years previously, and maybe your website just needs a revamp, it's extremely important to be able to have an online presence which represents your brand well, speaks to your target clients, and will allow you to be found online. I'm going to walk you through a tutorial on how to set up a website using Wix. To create your own website, click the link in the video description down below. Now, many of you may already know that I am a wedding photographer, and one branch of my photography business sells editing presets to other photographers. They utilize these presets on their computers in order to process those photos faster. Well, it's extremely important that that branch of my business has a professional website as well. So today I'm going to walk you through step by step everything I do in order to create a new website using Wix. First, you're going to be asked what kind of website you will be creating. Type it in and click Next. After that, you will then be given two different options: to either let Wix ADI create a website for you, or to create your own website using the editor. Today, I'm going to show you how to create your own website using Wix Editor. Select Edit a Template to start with a template and turn it completely customized to suit your own specific needs. Wix has a variety of different beautiful templates to choose from. Once you find a template that you like, click View and you'll be able to view the specific details of that site. Click Edit down in the bottom right-hand corner and then Wix will apply that template to your website. Now that we have applied the template to our website, we are ready to start customizing. I'm going to start over here on the left with the name of the page that is displayed here. I'm going to enter in the text so that it matches my website name. Next, I'm going to change the image that displays at the top header of the page. After clicking on Change Strip Background, I am then going to click on Image. This will then take me to an area where I can select to upload my own specific files. Once I have uploaded my files, I am then going to select the photo that I would like to display in the header. Next, I'm going to need to crop it so that it appears exactly how I want it to look. If I click again on Image over to the right, it's going to take me back into my media gallery. If I select on the photo that I would like to crop, then I will be able to find the crop icon, and I can then go in and specifically change the photo to look how I would like it to appear on the page. Once I have completed the crop, I'm going to click Save, and then I am going to click Change Background, and it will input the finalized cropped photo back into the header. Next, I'm going to click the Add button over here to add an element to my site. I'm going to be adding a rectangular background as well as some text to add a heading at the top of my page. It's easy to drag and drop everything to expand it, make it larger or smaller. I'm going to change the color of this rectangle, and I'm also going to make it transparent so that you can still see the photo. To add in my text, I am next going to click the Add button again, and then I am going to select the text option and select the size of text that I would like to input. Once this is input into my page, I will be able to customize the text. I will be able to drag it, drop it, edit the text in terms of color, size, and font. Now I want to show you one of my favorite features here, which actually seems like something small, but it makes a huge difference. It's a huge time saver. If you click here on the fill color of this icon or of anything that changes colors on this site, and you click over onto the color icon right here where you select the color, you will see theme colors pop up. These are completely customizable. And what you can do here is you can select the colors that you would like to have applied across the board for your brand on your website. Time that you are creating something that has color in it and you need to change the color, your branded colors will automatically populate for you and it saves a lot of time. To add a new block of content to your website, you are going to click the add, and over in the left hand side, you are going to click on strip. From there, you can select what type of strip you would like to add. This strip acts as a content block and you can then input other types of content within the strip. Within my strip, I am going to be adding in an image gallery. So I am going to first click the add button over on the left hand side. Then I will be able to select gallery and I'll be able to see all the different choices that Wix has for types of galleries that I can input into the strip. Once I have selected one, I will go ahead and click on it and it will then populate into. Next, click on change images, and here I'll be able to delete, add, and organize the images that are going into my gallery. I'm going to be using thumbnails that link to other pages and resources. So I am going to organize them how I'd like, and then over in the settings area for these images, I can also input links, which will take the viewer to the appropriate pages. Once this is done, then I will be able to drag it, drop it, resize it, and make it look exactly how I would like it to appear on the page. I'm going to adjust the strip boundary to make sure that it is exactly at the end of this block. Next, I'm going to add in another new strip just like before, and this time I'm going to add in an image. Now I'm going to customize this block so that the image stretches a little bit larger, and then I'm going to make sure that it's centered. Next, I am going to create some sort of an icon in the middle of this photo to act kind of as a title for my work that I'm showing here. So I'm going to click the rectangle once again, and I'm going to create it into a background for the logo that's going to go in the middle of this block. Now, if you're not able to locate the feature that you want to find, use the search bar on the right. I was looking for a frequently asked questions form, so I typed in FAQ. I was able to then locate the right application that I want to input, and I can now input it into the site by clicking Add to. Next, I will be able to edit the questions and answers text by clicking the Manage Questions button up above, clicking the edit pencil, and changing the text. Next, I'm going to add a new strip, and then I am going to be embedding a video player within that strip. Once I have added and stretched my strip large enough, I am going to select video and then single video player. In my next strip, I'm going to embed a contact form. Just like with everything else, the text can be customized, the colors changed, and you can change it to appear exactly on the page where you would like it to. Now next I'm going to add in a new strip, but I'm going to instead select the Services tab from the strip area. I am then going to select what I would like to input, and it will automatically populate for me. Next I'm going to customize this to be on brand and have my own unique information in it. Using the text settings on the right hand side, I'm able to select the type of theme that I would like for my text, the font, the size, and the color. Change the background image, I'm going to click on the image itself and click on Change Strip Background. Next, I'll click on Image and I will select the image that I would like to appear in the background. Next, I'm going to customize these background colors on each column. So I'm going to click on the column background, and then I'm going to select the color from my preloaded theme colors here so that it matches up with my brand. Now I went ahead and I added in some additional image files, some additional galleries, etc., using these steps that I have already shown. Next, I want to see exactly how my site looks from a pulled back version so that I can see if I want to reorganize or delete any blocks. Up in the top area here, I am going to go ahead and click on this zoom icon, and it will show me a zoomed out version where I can reorder or delete different content blocks. If I'd like to reorder a content block, I simply click on the block and click the arrow going up or down based on where I would like the block to move to. there any blocks or spaces that need to be deleted, I simply can click on that area. And then over to the right-hand side, I will be able to click to delete this. Next, I'm going to be able to preview what the desktop version of the website looks like, as well as viewing what the mobile version of the site looks like. Now, you may want to open up the mobile version and ensure that everything looks okay, because sometimes certain elements don't translate very well in a mobile device. So here we'll be able to see if anything needs to be removed, changed, or reordered to make sense when viewed on a mobile device. Changing these items on the mobile editor does not change them on the desktop site, so you are able to click back over and view your full website to ensure that everything is still in order. Okay, you guys, so I hope that was helpful. I hope that was interesting to see the entire process from start to finish. From start to finish, creating this site took me less than 2 hours. If you'd like to create your own website using Wix, click the link in the video description. Please click like, subscribe, and leave me a comment down below.